couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the academy was a crime against natural philosophy itself.
Which you might have pointed out at the time.
Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields of battle with ease, but Sokolov and I are not as gifted in the same way. Without the arc pylon, it is only a matter of time before they put an end to us. We can get this device working, or you can go out and remove our enemies one by one, whichever you think is best.
None of this would have gotten so bad if that damn fool Corvo hadn't killed the Empress.
Stupid rat. Plague. Lecture.
Look out. We got someone skulking around.
What? You're being...
Someone help me!
There's no one they can run to.
Pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? I should have guessed you'd want to act decisively. It's a simple adjustment, and we will be ready. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honor?
When this arc pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
amazing. Destruction on a grand scale. Defies description. So many lives silent.